Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm about to boldly go where I think every critic has gone before, and that is to talk about the new Star Trek movie. Look, I'm not a Trekker, I admit that. I don't sit home and just go through video after video, DVD, Blu-ray on the first season. There have been 10 Star Trek movies, umpteen different versions of the series that started in the 60s with William Shatner as James Tiberius Kirk and Leonard Nimoy as Mr. Spock. But, you know, it just wasn't for me. I watched it sometimes, not all the time. So when I came to this movie, I thought, tired. It's just so tired. Even though I like very much J.J. Abrams, the director, because he does Lost on TV, and that's one of my favorite shows. And you know what? I sat there and I said, wow, this is the summer movie that Wolverine should have been. This is the one that works. It's an origin story, so everybody's young. They're just beginning. We are seeing Chris Pine, I think, in a star-making performance as James T. Kirk. Arrogant, he's got a little of that William Shatner swagger. It's all going for him. And you have Zachary Quinto, who is on Heroes, who plays Siler, one of the evilest villains on TV, doing Spock and doing him brilliantly, giving him a soul in this movie. Because look at them. These guys are basically all just starting their careers. They're not in control of anything. Zachary Quinto Spock, in fact, may have more power than Kirk does at the beginning. But we see them at the Academy, and we realize that Spock, as a Vulcan, has a human mother. This mother is played by Winona Ryder. I mean, I want to say, OMFG, like they say on Gossip Girl. I mean, what is that about? I mean, she's only about 2 years older than Zachary Quinto, and she's playing his mother, but that's a whole other story. She's really good in it. Everybody in this movie is really good, but especially Chris Pine and Zachary Quinto. To see Spock at the Academy being told that he's been accepted into the Science Academy, and they said, we're accepting you, even though you basically have this handicap. And he said, what's that handicap? And they say, you have a human mother. I've never seen anybody use the line, anybody who's ever done Spock from Leonard Nimoy on, do the line, live long and prosper, as such a screw you salute. I mean, this guy is saying to them, forget it, I don't want to be in your academy. Look, the plot itself is time travel-y. It's written by the guys who do Transformers. I hated that movie. But what they do here, I don't understand at all. I don't know what this time travel thing is, but I didn't care because everything works. The casting works. Zoe Saldana as Uhura, the communications officer, who is being hit on hard by Kirk, but really has a thing for Spock. We've got Sulu back, and we've got Chekhov back, and Sulu is played by Harold from Harold and Kumar. That's John Cho. So you're looking at everybody again, and you're finding new life in it. What more do you want from any of those people? I was actually tremendously touched at the moment in this movie where Spock looks at Kirk and says, I have been and always shall be your friend. If you can actually get moved by a movie that's full of explosions and things with ships, something is being done right. Now, one of the things that I just couldn't do right was I can't do the Vulcan salute. I was talking to Zachary Quinto recently, and I tried to do the Vulcan salute for him, and I couldn't. My ring finger and my pinky finger just will not go together. So I asked him, what's the matter? And he said that he was left-handed like I was, and we left-handed people have a problem with it. But what he did was he took rubber bands and for 3 months before he shot this movie, put those two fingers together. So thanks to Zachary Quinto, I can actually do this. I can give you the Vulcan salute and I can say, live long and prosper. You know, amazing. So Scumbucket, you're thinking, what am I going to do this week? You know, there's almost nothing else that's opening and I love Star Trek and when am I going to say that all summer? You know crap is coming. I have to go back to the 10 movies that were made from Star Trek, you know, and I mean, there's only really one good one, and that was the second one. It was Star Trek: The Wrath of Khan, and it worked tremendously well, but the worst one ever is Star Trek V, The Final Frontier, starring William Shatner in the part that made him a star, and directed by William Shatner from an idea by William Shatner. Now, look, I've met Shatner. I love this guy. But here, his pomposity that he would later tease when he played Denny Crane on Boston Legal was just in full flower. This movie is horrible. I called it at the time I reviewed it for Rolling Stone. I put a headline on it that said, "Windbags at Warp Speed." And usually you don't get letters from people when you write nasty reviews. Maybe they just have little dolls at home and stick things in them. But William Shatner very nicely ripped out that review I wrote on his movie, folded it up, and in red magic marker sent to me a note that said, "Fuck you, Bill Shatner." You know, and he signed it, Bill. You know, I was touched by that. I loved it so much that I've kept that. I have it framed in my house, and I look at it often thinking it's the best reaction to anything I've ever seen. Look, I watched Star Trek V: Final Frontier again. It's as bad as it's ever been. I mean, it's Captain Kirk and William Shatner's ego saying, "Who can I take on?" It's God, and it goes to heaven. And heaven in this movie is basically the California desert tinted red. It's awful. It is scumbucket material. And I know you're going to go back and look at other Star Trek movies. Don't look at that one. Look at this new one, because the new Star Trek is really, really great. So beam me up, Scotty. I'm ready for more.